A very warm welcome in this video lesson of NIOS D.El.Ed program, course code 502, unit 12 on computer assisted learning. Our today's topic for this lesson is computer, its major components, basic knowledge of computer operations. Before going on the topic, let me share with you the proposed flow of the lesson. First of all, I will share with you the lesson guide. Then I will share with you the expectations in terms of learning objectives and learning outcome. Then we will discuss what is the computer. We will also discuss about the basic computer operations and its functional unit. We will also discuss about the major component of computer. At the end of the lesson, we will recapitulate and there is a take-home task also. Now, the lesson guide says that during the presentation, I will explain all the concepts in detail. You need to attend to my voice and the slides as well. You will find important words and sentences have been highlighted for your retention by me. I have also put summary at the end for your retention. There are also some questions or exercises in between and at the end of my presentation. You must attempt these questions and exercises after going through this video lesson. Now, it's story time. Let me share an incident with you. One day my grandmother came home from bank. She was surprised and told me that it took only 5 minutes in the bank to complete whatever she wanted. To quote her, there was something on which the bank employees were working. That magical thing was following all their commands and everything was getting in place in seconds. She was calling that machine the magical black box. The magical black box with wires here and there. I told her the name of the machine which facilitated the functioning of bank employees. Can you tell me the name of machine which my grandma has seen in the bank? Yes, my dear learner, it's computer. Computer has changed our life completely. It has added to its space. It has added to our knowledge. It has changed our life completely. And therefore, in educational scenario also, it has made a major difference. The characteristics of learner have been changed thoroughly due to advent of technology and computer into the educational scenario. Now, the knowledge is not longer been in teacher's control. It comes under students' control. We need to have learner-centered environment and we need to have learner-centered system of our education as the knowledge is just away a one click. The classroom context has also been changed. Through the advent of computer and through the inclusion of educational technology, we can bring simulation into the classroom. Simulation is the condition which is just near to real life situation. That means we can bring life to our classroom. Computers have facilitated democratic learning also. And my dear learner, computer can be considered as the greatest invention of the mankind on this earth. Computers can be used in business and industry, in production field, in publication field, in education field obviously, in government organization, in medical field, in science field, and in entertainment field. You think of any sphere of human life, computer is there. It is just like an inseparable part of our life. Now, coming on, what is computer? How we define computer? Computer can be defined as a programmable machine which has artificial intelligence. Yes, my dear learners, computer is intelligent, but in that intelligence is dependent upon its software. There is programming which facilitate the operation of computers. Computer is a machine that takes raw data as input from the users and it processes the data under the control of set instructions which are called programs and the result given is called output. It also saves the output for future purpose in its storage. Therefore, it can be said that computer is a machine, it's a programmable machine which processes both numerical and non-numerical data and also facilitate the saving of that processing in terms of results or output. Now, coming on the characteristics of computer. Computer has speed. Whatever we do in hours, in months, and in years, computer can do it in seconds. It has accuracy because computer is free from human error. We can get fatigued, we can get tired, but not our computer system. It has diligence. Diligence means it is highly consistent as machine. It doesn't get bored and tired due to repeated kind of tasks. It is better than human beings in performing voluminous and repetitive jobs. Computer has versatility. It can perform multiple tasks at the same time. And it has also the storage capacity. It means that it can store different kind of data into it and in its periphery. Now coming on, what are the basic computer operations and functional units? My dear learners, when I have defined computer, I have stressed upon some words which are input, which are process, and which are output. So, on the diagram which has been shown on your screen, the basic computer operation is exhibited in which the computer takes data in terms of program and raw data from outside through input units. Then that data goes into storage unit, and in storage unit, the central processing unit performs processing on that data which has been received from outside, and then the output unit gives the results in terms of the final output. Here in the diagram, dotted lines indicated the flow of instruction and solid line indicates the flow of data. Now we are going to take all the computer operations one by one, along with highlighting the functional units and also the devices which are there involved in computer, different computer operations. First of all, we will talk about the input. What is input? Input can be defined as the process of entering data and programs into the computer system. It can also be seen as the raw data on which the processing is required to be done. There are different kind of input devices through which we enter data into our computer system for further processing. There is an device which is input device which is called keyboard. You must have seen the old typewriter in which we press different keys and get the output on the paper. Similarly, our computer system also has keyboard on which we can press the different keys and have output on its screen. Then there is a mouse which controls the movement of the pointer on the display screen of the computer. Then there could be a camera through which we can enter live visuals into the computer system. Then there could be a microphone through which we can enter sound data into the computer system. There could be a trackball also as input device with your computer through which we can enter motion data. You must have played, all of you must have played the video games in which you are having a round circular kind of input device which is called the trackball through which we enter motion data into the computer. Then we have touchpad. Touchpad is a device for pointing or controlling the input's positioning on screen. Then there is a light pen. Light pen has light sensitive detector into it which selects the objects on screen. In other inputs unit, we are having magnetic ink character recognizer which is called in abbreviation as MICR or MICR. It identifies character printed on with a magnetic ink. Then we are having optical mark recognition which is called OMR. My dear friends, you have, all of you have been appeared in some entrance examination where we are having OMR sheets on which if we mark something, it get recognized by through the optical mark recognition system only, which is a kind of input device. This optical mark recognition system senses or read the marks which is there on the paper. Then there is a barcode reader. Barcode reader is photoelectrical and it reads the photoelectrical inputs which is there on different kind of products we purchase from supermarkets, on the back of the books we purchase from different publishers. Barcoding is invariably there on all kind of products we are having, we are using in our life. Then there is a scanner. Scanner can be defined as input device which converts the input from hard form to the soft form. That is, it converts, it projects the paper into a soft form on a computer screen. Now coming on the storage or storage unit as in basic computer operations and functional unit. Storage or storage unit can be defined as a process of saving data and instruction fed. It can also be seen as the process of saving the output, and there are different places of storage such as ROM, which is called read-only memory, and RAM, which is called random access memory. Read-only memory is the basic memory of the computers in which the basic functions and basic programs, which are company programs, are written and existing in the computer. However, random access memory is the main memory of the computer through which the computer facilitates the functioning. Coming on different kind of storage devices, we are having hard disk, which is kind of bulky device in which we store data. There are two kind of hard disk. One is there inside your computer and one is external hard disk. In both the hard disks, we save data. External hard disk is detachable hard disk, which could be detached from the computer system after saying into different kind of inputs. Then there is compact disk, which is popularly known as CD. Then we are having digital video disc, which are popularly known as DVDs. On CDs, we can write the things, we can save the things, but usually we cannot change the things. But on DVDs, there are two kind of DVDs. One are non-rewritable DVDs and one are rewritable DVDs. In DVDs, we can store different kind of data, such as visual data, video data, sound data, and we can also edit them in rewritable DVDs. Then we are having USB or pen drives, which are popularly known as pen drives, and pen drives have different storage capacity. We are having pen drives of storage space of 1 GB till 100 GB. Then there are small chips which are called memory cards, and there are zip drivers also, which can be considered as input devices. Coming on output unit or output devices as basic computer operations and functional unit, output device can be defined as the result. Output can be defined as the result of processing on raw data entered, and output unit can be known or defined as the unit which is used for storing the results as output produced by the computer system after its processing. Coming on the output devices, what different kind of output devices are there attached with our computer? The first and primary output device is monitor, which is popularly known as computer screen or display screen. Then there is a printer, which converts the soft output into the hard output or the paper product. Then we are having plotter, through which we print graphical output on the paper. My dear learners, you have seen the printer of your photographer, which is actually a plotter, which prints the graphical output on the paper. Then there is facsimile, which is called fax popularly, which sends and receives picture and text over a telephone line. It is also attached with your computer to send and receive different kind of messages through your telephone line. Then there are speakers, which gives the output in terms of sound bites. Now coming on the processing units or processing as an basic operation, computer operation. Processing can be understood as the task of performing different kind of operations, which can be arithmetic in its nature or logical in its nature. When I am talking about arithmetic operations are invariably in number forms, and logical operations are invariably in word form. And processing units can be considered as a space where the data is processed for the storage. Processing units has three components into it, and the first major component of the processing unit is central processing unit, which is popularly known as CPU. CPU takes data and instruction from storage unit. It makes all sorts of calculations based on the instructions given and the type of data provided. For example, if it is arithmetic data, the CPU will process it accordingly, or if it is logical data, the CPU will process it accordingly. It is then sent back to the storage unit. CPU includes the two other units of the central processing unit, which are arithmetic logic unit, popularly known as ALU, and control unit. Arithmetic logical unit, or ALU, carries calculations and comparisons, which means that arithmetic logical units primarily operates upon the numbers or numerical data. It also performs arithmetic and logical functions. My dear friends, you must have heard about the computer spreadsheets. The spreadsheets are primarily functioning on the basis of arithmetic and logical unit. The data fed on the spreadsheets is primarily processed by the arithmetic and logical unit. Then comes the control unit, which is the subunit of CPU and a unit under the processing unit of the computer. The control units also take care of step-by-step processing of all operations inside the computer. To culminate, we can say that computer performs through its hardware and software. All the operations and processing units of the computer can be categorized into the two categories. One is the category of hardware and one is the category of software. Hardware is the machine itself and its connected devices such as monitor, keyboard, mouse, etc. External storage units, external input devices, external output devices, whatever you can feel, sense, see through your senses comes under the hardware. Then comes the software of the computer, which is a set of program that makes the hardware perform a set of tasks in particular order. And hardware and software are complementary to each other. One computer cannot operate without hardware and also cannot operate without software. Each of them complements each other. Now, at the culmination, I would try to highlight all those things which we have discussed in this lesson. Computers have added lots to our life. Let's quickly look through whatever I have discussed with you in this lesson. Computer is a machine which processes arithmetic and logical data. It is there in all the sphere of human functioning. It ensures speeds and accuracy in the results. Its operations include providing input, processing the input provided, and generation of output. These operations get completed through a number of devices categorized according to their functioning into input devices, processing unit, output, and storage devices. In short, it can be said that grandma's magical machine casts all its magical spell through its hardware, that is its body, and through its software, that is its soul. So learner, let's keep this magical spell goes on till we meet the next. But before that, I am having a take-home task for you. You are required to make a list of the various input, output, and storage devices used by your computer using friends and people known to you. With these words, I thank you all and I wait for you in another video lesson. Till then, bye-bye. Thank you.